Hi, welcome to Learning Monkey. I am Raghuveer. In this class, we will discuss about saddle point. In our previous classes, we discussed about convex and non-convex functions. This is a continuation class. Please follow our playlist from the beginning so that you will have a better understanding of the complete deep learning concepts. The link for the playlist is provided in the description below. Coming to today's class, let's take an example and understand what saddle point is. The example which we consider here is, let's assume this function. This is our function which we considered, and the point that's shown here, the red color point, that point we call it as a saddle point. What we understand from this saddle point, at the saddle point, the function is almost linear. If the function is linear, if you differentiate this function with respect to x and if you substitute the x value at this point, we will get the differentiation value as 0. The same thing we get for the convex functions, the minimum point. Let's take this example. This is our convex function. At the minimum point, the slope value is 0. If you differentiate this function and substitute the x value, this minimum point, we'll get the differentiation value as 0. The basics about differentiation value, how we are getting this slope value, all these concepts were clearly discussed in our machine learning. First 1 to 13 classes, based on the assumption that you already watched those classes, based on that we are continuing this class. So what's the problem with this saddle point? What we have understand from the given example is, at minimum point the differentiation value is 0, at saddle point also the differentiation value is 0. That's why we'll get a problem of see, in our last classes when we discussed about machine learning or neural networks, what we are doing, we are randomly selecting some weights and we are keeps on updating our weights based on the differentiation value, based on the slope value. If our differentiation value is 0, our weights are not at all updating. The equation is W1 new is equal to W1 old minus alpha into differentiation value dou f by dou x. That is what we are doing. If the differentiation value is 0, our weights are not at all updating. These points were discussed previously. If the points are not updated, means we think that we are approached to the minimum point, means convergence happens. But there is a chance to stuck at the saddle point. The saddle point is not minimum point, not maximum point. Take a look at the function. Is it minimum point? It is not minimum point. It is not maximum point. But still, the differentiation value is 0. Our weights are stuck at saddle point. We are not going towards the minimum point. This saddle point problem, we'll get it, this problem in non-convex function, means we will get this problem in neural networks. We have to get away from the saddle point. We should not stuck at this saddle point. That we have to do. How we do it mathematically, we will understand in our next classes. In this class, we will give you graphical intuition. This graphical intuition will help you a lot in understanding the mathematical equations which we discuss in our later classes. So please follow the class completely. It is very, very important to understand this graphical intuition. Let's take one more example in three-dimensional space. So we are taking two variables, and we will show the saddle point in the three-dimensional space so that you will have a better understanding of what saddle point is. The example which we consider here is f of xy is equal to x square minus y square. This is the function. The function looks like this. Take a look at the function. It looks like this. Take a look at this function. It's very, very important. The point which shows here, this point we call it as saddle point. Why we call it a saddle point? Let's try to understand with the equations. Differentiate this function with respect to x and equate to and the differentiation value we got it as 2x. Equate this 2x is equal to 0, x is equal to 0. Differentiate this function with respect to y, we got minus 2y, minus 3y equate to 0, y is equal to 0. Means at 0, 0, differentiate this function with respect to x, place x is equal to 0. The differentiation value we are getting it as 0. The differentiation with this function with respect to y and substitute y is equal to 0, we are getting a value of 0. Means at 0, 0, the differentiation values are zeros. We think that this is the minimum point, but it is not the minimum point. It is saddle point. At 0, 0, we are having saddle point. Why it is saddle point? Let's try to graphically understand it. Let's take this. This is x direction. This is y direction. in the x direction, differentiate this function with respect to x at this point. Our differentiation value is 0. This is showing it as local minima. From the x perspective, this is showing it as local minima. Take the y direction, means in this direction, differentiate this function with respect to y. At this point, the differentiation value is showing it as zero. But from the y perspective, it is showing it as local maxima. X perspective, it is showing it as local minima. Y perspective, it is showing it as local maxima. That's why we call it a saddle point. This is not minimum point. If it is minimum point, it will be like this. From the x perspective, it is showing it as minimum point. From the y perspective, it is showing it as minimum point. But in the y perspective, it is showing it as local maxima. This point is very, very important to understand. So that's why we call it a saddle point. We should not stuck at this saddle point. We have to get away from this saddle point. So the graphical intrusion, I will tell you the graphical intrusion here. How we will avoid this graphically, we will show you. But the mathematical equations we will clearly discuss in our next class. So how to avoid this graphical, this saddle point problem? We should not stuck at this. We have to move away from this saddle point. Let's take a look at this. From the y perspective, in the y direction, if you differentiate this value from here, at this point, the differentiation value is almost near to 0. It is almost near to 0 and it's almost 0. Means our weights are not at all updating. If you take a long jump from this point, from the saddle point, if you take a long jump in the y direction, what happens? We will go into the other side of the y direction. In the y direction, we are moving to the other side. So how it looks like? On the other side, we are having a slope like this. Means the y value on the other side is less when compared to the y value at the saddle point. This point keep in the mind. You will understand how we will get away from the saddle point by taking the equation. See, it is very, very important. Take a look at this. From the saddle point, if you take a long jump, we are moving to the minimum y value. How to take that long jump? That is important. Let's take an example. Equations, x nu is equal to x old minus alpha into dou f by dou x, y nu is equal to y old minus y alpha into dou f by dou y. These are the equations which we use for updating our x and y value moving towards the minimum point. If you are at the saddle point, what happens? This differentiation value is 0, this differentiation value is 0. Our x and y values are not at all updating and we are stuck at a saddle point. How to avoid this? To avoid this, what we are doing here is x nu is equal to x old minus alpha into, for the differentiation value, we are adding some value. Which value we have to add? That we will discuss in our next classes. For understanding purpose, we are taking it as 10. Means we are adding some value, the value is 10. The same way, y old minus alpha into dou f by dou y plus 10. If the differentiation value is small, means it is very small, it is 0, still we are taking a long step because we are adding some value, we are taking a long jump. On the y direction, if you take a long jump, we are getting new y as the minimum y. We are getting the minimum y value. If you take the y value, if you update the y value, if you take a long jump, the y value will be minimum value. Once we got the minimum value, what's our gradient descent algorithm will do? In the next iteration, always our gradient descent algorithm will try to travel towards the minimum point. So please take a look at the gradient descent. It's very, very important. So from the next step onwards, we are moving towards the y minimum point. That is how we are avoiding the saddle point. By adding this constant, and one more important point we have to understand, by adding this constant, are we really getting stuck at the minimum point, or we are getting any problem in the real minimum point? Let's take an example. Let's take the real minimum point. Let's take a three-dimensional convex function, and this function looks like this. This center point, we call it as minimum point. By adding this constant value, are we getting any problems at this minimum point? Are we getting away from the minimum point, or we are or we are staying at the minimum point. That point we have to understand. So in order to explain this, we will explain this in the two-dimensional space for better understanding. You please elaborate in the three-dimensional space. Let's assume that in the three-dimensional space, this is the real minimum point. So if the x value is here, so the differentiation value at this point will be very, very, very small. If you take it by adding the extra value, we are taking a long jump, means our x value moves from here to this side. So these concepts, gradient descent, we clearly explained, we are moving from here to this side. What happens if you come to this side? X value is increasing. In our next iteration, what's our gradient descent algorithm will do? Our x value will, next iteration, it will jump to this side, this side, this side, this side. We will swing here and here only. We are not getting away from the minimum point, if it is real minimum point. Okay, the same way, identify in the y direction also. If it is, if our function is like this, our y is also not getting away from the minimum point. It is staying, it is swinging at the minimum point. We are not getting away from the minimum point. Only at the saddle point, we are getting away from the minimum saddle point. Why? By adding this extra constant, extra value. It's not constant. We will understand when we discuss the equations in our next classes. By adding this, we are taking a long jump. By taking that long jump, we are moving to the other side of the y. Other side is, we are having the less y value. So keeps on, y value keeps on decreasing from there. Because gradient, we are applying gradient descent. Whenever we apply gradient descent, our gradient descent algorithm always tries to move towards the minimum point. So once you take that jump, from there onwards, we are keep on moving to the minimum point. That is how we will avoid the saddle point. Hope you understand the concept. This graphical intuition is very, very important in understanding our next classes. So please watch this class again and again till you get the clarity. If you have any questions regarding the concept, please post your questions in the comment section below. Thanks for watching. If you haven't subscribed to our channel, please subscribe to our channel and press bell icon for the latest updates. Thank you.